Welcome to the sixth grade Super Bowl here at Mountain Brook Stadium. George Palakis along with Rob Wetzler here for the big game against the number one Jets, regular season champs, versus number two Vikings. We're now going to kick it over to Wayne Trucks with the announcement of the players, introduction of the players.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to the sixth grade Super Bowl between the Jets. This is when you applaud. The Jets and the Vikings. For your lineups, first for the Jets, number 00, Walker Ray. Number 1, John Colvin. Number 2, Frank Barton. Number 3, Lewis Howland. Number 5, Howell Fell. Number 7, Jacob Rosenthal. Number 8, Slate Sokol. Number 9, Gry Cascio. Number 10, Heath Griffin. Number 11, Rob Gillespie. Number 15, Jackson Young. Number 23, Parker Belt. Number 27, Will Troiano. Number 79, Jay Davis. And the coaches for the Jets, Matt O'Rear, Boyd Dobbin, and Howie Fell. And now for your Vikings. Number 1, Lawson Evans. Number 2, Matt Massengill. Number 4, Spence Morano. Number 7, Coleman Bates. Number 8, Eli Bear. Number 13, Sam McPherson. Number 34, Daniel Cubison. Number 42, Thomas Marriott. Number 43, John Hendry. Number 52, Trent Wright. Number 74, Ray Vickers. Number 83, George Palakis. And number 89, Wells Marks. Your coaching staff for the Vikings, Douglas Grant and Chuck Bowers.
All righty, thank you, Wayne. Back here with George Palakis and Rob Wetzler. And here we are with the Jets versus the Vikings. We see it's go time, go Jets. And we see Valhalla, I'm a-coming.
Under the lights at Spartan Stadium, the sixth grade Super Bowl. It doesn't get any better than this.
Doesn't get any better than this. This will be the last time these guys are green and white and purple and gold. They'll soon be green and gold. So their last opportunity to play in the NBA athletics. And next year they'll be all together.
I've heard about this grade and the talent in this grade for 5 years.
And it's coming.
That's the first grade Metro baseball.
Well, this is a great group of guys on both teams. And here come the Jets firing through their banner here with the flag in the green and white, slapping each other around, excited for today's game. Meeting with the referees right now. And here come your Vikings. Storming the field and being brought on by the Viking, the lead Viking there.
Off the field. If you're not wearing a jersey or a helmet.
And here we go. We got
leave the field.
We have the PA announcer, Wayne Trucks, telling everybody to please get off the field if you do not have a jersey in such a commanding way.
He may get permanently hired.
Yeah, I'm about to say.
Very impressed.
You can tell he works in the schools, the high school systems.
That's right.
In the state of Alabama. So we'll look for the team captains as both teams are giving instructions. What a great job this year by Chuck Bowers and Douglas Grant for the Vikings, and then for the Jets, Matt O'Rear and Boyd Dobbin and Howie Fell, who helps out. Just fantastic job, two class acts. And we see the team captains for the Jets. It looks like it's number 67, Mr. Toriano, Will. And it looks like number one, John Colvin, and number 10, Heath Griffin. For the Vikings, number 34, Daniel Cubison, number 43, the bus, Big John Hendry. Number 52, Trent Wright. Number two, Mr. Matt Massengill. And number, I'm trying to see that, it looks like, that looks like Mr. Eli Bear right there, number eight, who is the center. Once again, number eight that's on there.
Remember that orders for DVDs at tonight's game are currently being taken.
So as we see, the press box. The referees going over with the with both teams. We see on both sides the green and white and the purple and gold getting ready, taking it all in. Rob, this is exciting. So these teams have met twice in the regular season. The first time the Jets won 18-6. The second time the Vikings won 19-6.
This is exactly what you want for a Super Bowl.
It is what you want for a Super Bowl.
Both Anything teams, can happen.
Both teams, Vikings would be more of a single wing running team. Jets are more open spread offense kind, and John Colvin will be a throwing deep.
The left-handed gunslinger.
The left-handed gunslinger, and then you'll see a bunch of just talent on both sides of this. You'll know.
I just go through these names, and these are all little brothers. This is going to be interesting because there's some Mountain Brook Hall of Fame members that are big brothers of these guys.
That's right. Well, it looks like the Jets are going to be receiving, and so they will. There's no kickoffs in sixth grade football, so they will take the snap from the 30 to start off sixth grade Super Bowl here at Mountain Brook Spartan Stadium. Vikings in their 6-2 defense. The Jets showing their wing. Handoff up to Heath Griffin, and looks like, oh, big Sam McPherson, number 13 for the Vikings, coming from the in position to make the tackle. You see old Heath Griffin, number 10. He's, I mean, one of those. You'll see him in every sport, just a spectacular player. Old Sam McPherson, the hammer he likes to go by. Jets are second down and about 6 yards, 7 yards to go. Snap. Oh, Jacob Roosevelt takes it around the left end. And it looks like number 42, the defensive end on that, or the cornerback on that side, Thomas Marriott on the tackle. And it looked like Daniel Cubison, number 34, making the hit.
A good pursuit by Daniel.
Third down and three for the Jets.
And you look at some of the Thomas Marriott had a cast on, as the Vikings are the first team to have a team that got drafted with two guys with cast on their arms that couldn't play the first part of the season. And Thomas was one of them. It's great to see him back out there. Third down and four to go. He takes it right up the middle. And it looks like the host of Vikings are there to push it back.
Really close.
2.5 yards.
Toriano was just moving the pile.
And I'm about to say, I like to say with Mr. Toriano, his first name is Will. Will keep on turning. I'll tell you what, turn it up. Will has got quick feet. He is going to be a great left tackle.
Takes after his uncle, Donnie Toriano.
I'm about to say, and his old daddy, too.
Yeah. And Corey Toriano.
Corey played a bunch of ball.
Donnie dominated is what I heard.
Donnie dominated.
He'll say Corey tried to dominate.
Here we go, fourth in, about a yard and a half for the Jets, going for it here in the first quarter, 7:48 to go. Scoreless. Oh, and John Colvin's going to reach back and throw. He's got a wide open number nine for the – that's Gry Cascio with a great catch.
What a catch. What a throw.
What a play call by the Jets. And there you go. He sneaked Gry off the line of scrimmage there to make a great catch, put it right in the basket.
It's southpaw. It's hard. You start looking right, and then next thing it's coming left.
But what a fabulous catch by number nine, Gracacio. Right over his shoulder, put it right in his breadbasket. He hauled it in for a first down for the Jets. 7:07 to go in a scoreless ball game. Colvin behind center.
Got some dancing. The illegal procedure on the Jets.
And I'll tell you what, number three, Lewis Highland, the center for the Jets. Really good snaps here. As we always talk about, the center is probably one of the toughest positions to play. It gets the offense a start.
But so critical. So critical. Success. A fast snap can get the play moving so fast, can get your guy one more step to the line. It's critical.
Lewis is a big Dolphins fan, and he'd be very probably proud to know that Kent Drake ran one back today.
Oh,
for a touchdown.
Good to hear.
There you go. Heath Griffin takes it to the left, moves around. Oh, big number 52, Trent Wright, jumps on top for a ride to make a tackle. Heath has a good first down run of about 6 yards. Make it second down and 7 to go. Vikings in the traditional NBA athletics 6-2 defense. The Jets showing what I would call a double wing. But now let's see. Here we go.
A little razzle-dazzle. Mix it up.
He takes it around. They try to seal the edge. Oh, Coleman Bates, number 7, around there. But then he looks like, look at that, Coleman Bates, number 34.
Number 43 got in there, John Hendry.
John Hendry.
Good stick.
And number 34, Daniel Cubison in there. Number 7, Coleman Bates. Third down and about 4 to go. Great job blocking up there up front by the Jets. See Rob Gillespie, number 11, with some good blocks in there.
Trent Wright got up in the hole. 52, I guess that's a Ray Lewis.
That's right. And there you go, third down snap. Handed off to Jacob Rosenthal, who finds a crease. And that's going to
be really close.
Really close. Once again, a host of Vikings on the tackle. Trent Wright, Matt Massengill. Look like Spence Morano in there. Fourth down and 1. We saw a pass play on the last fourth down. 4:53 to go here in the first quarter.
Looks scoreless like ball game. Passing package in.
That's right, the passing package. That's right.
Air Colvin, as they call it.
I tell you what, I see Big Frank the Tank Barton right there, right guard. Wouldn't be surprised if they run right behind him. Oh, they run to the right, to the left, to the left, and oh!
He is going
to
get it.
Great second effort by Heath. Great job by the Vikings that time to contain it. But Heath finding the spot to get to make the tackle. Reed Vickers coming off the field, and looks like Mr. Marks coming into the ball. Wells Marks coming in the ball game.
Tell you what, we got a ball game. This is going to be a battle. You can tell by the intensity.
And what we got is Jets took the opening kickoff and are marching right now. 4 minutes to go. Just grinding. Look at this. We see four receivers out. Heath with a quick pass, and Matt Massengill comes up to meet him. And Trent Wright, 52, to finish it off.
Second down.
Good pass by John Colvin, just swinging it out quickly.
Quick pass.
That's one of those kind of like what you call a toss sweep. Get the ball quickly out there on the edge, and it's like almost like get the blockers out in front of you.
Coach Grant and Coach Bowers.
Second down and about 6 to go. And Colvin takes the snap, hands it off to Jacob Rosenthal, who comes back, counters back the other way, but doesn't fool number 4, Spence Morano, who missiles up there and makes the big hit.
Matt Massengill got in there as well. A great stop to slow him down.
Matt is known as the stroker.
The stroker.
He likes to get in there and mix it up. And I tell you, Spence Morano, I like to call him the missile. He will missile through there and make some hits. And you, Jets are in the huddle right now. Big third down play for them. Third and about six. They've had fourth down twice and have gone forward and made it. John Colvin, quarterback. Heath, running back. Oh, he's throwing it deep, and he's got behind. Look at that grind. Cassio makes a superior catch over the defense.
Wow.
What a terrific play by number nine.
We could have used
Gry Cassio.
Friday night.
Friday night. Good. And that's the great thing is Coach Yeager's looking at all this talent on the side.
He's on the sidelines making notes.
And I tell you, what a touchdown. Because I'm sitting here looking at the back of the end zone thinking, but touchdown pass, I should say. But a terrific catch. Gry running a perfect pattern. Colvin takes it. Sort of, you see Heath go out to the left, and then boom, he just throws it deep, and Gry catches it at its highest point.
Looks like we're going for two here.
Yes, on the ball's on the 5-yard line. Jets take the opening kickoff and have gone up 6-0 here. Hand off. Oh, no, another pass right there in the middle. Jacob Rosenthal for a touchdown for the extra point, 2 points to go up 8-0.
What a great drive.
Great drive. Exciting. John Colvin takes a snap, sees Jacob roll right behind the linebackers, and just a terrific throw.
Two phenomenal coaching staffs. My older son got to play for both of these coaches in his experience, and both were just outstanding years. A lot of competitive football, and just preparing these guys to all be on that same team in a very short period of time.
And if all of our fellows can follow Will Wetzler, I'll tell you what a leader.
Well, he's got a great group. That whole grade has turned out to just all be on the same page. It's been a lot of fun watching.
There's the big bust, John Henry taking the direct snap up the middle, and you see it 4 or 5 yards.
So much of the success of our high school program depends on the cohesiveness of the grade. Without that, you know, you can have some standout stars, but if everybody's not on the same page, it can go south really quick, and we've been very fortunate.
Well, if we can model what the senior class has done, this class will be very successful. There he goes, another direct snap to Matt Massengill, who takes it over the right side, and good blocking over there by the Vikings. Good tackle, looks like, who was it? Number 10, Heath Griffin. Second down and about a yard, or third down and a yard to go.
And one for the Vikings.
I tell you, on the quarterback of ours is the center, Eli Bear, on that Viking side. And he's another one where it gets started. There's a snap to the bus. Big John Henry. Ooh, he gets met.
That was a stick.
And that looked like number 10, Heath Griffin. And John Colvin coming in there and mixing it up, too. And I tell you what, great tackle, making it fourth and one. Jets have come out to play. And it's 48 seconds dwindling down here in the first quarter. Jets up 8-0. Fourth down. The Jets show they went for fourth down twice and converted. Let's see what the Vikings do. The wedge, direct hit snap to Massengill, who gets it over and will determine the spot.
He's got it.
And that might be the last play of the first quarter here. We got first down, 17 seconds. Let's see if they're going to call them on over. And so while we got at the end of the first quarter, the Jets taking the opening kickoff and taking it in and getting the extra point up 8-0 here on Super Bowl 6th grade, Super Bowl Sunday.
Let me tell you something you don't let in. Nothing come between us.
On this team, we fight.
And we shut them down because we can.
Five seconds left in the game. You believe in miracles?
Welcome back to Super Bowl Sunday here Vikings got the ball, first down, moving. We'd like to thank a couple of our sponsors real quick. NBA would like to thank R360 for their sponsorship of today's game. And we'd also like to thank UAB Sports Medicine for providing certified athletic trainers for all games. So here we go, first down, start the second quarter. Vikings have the ball. They're single wing. Matt Massengill takes it over the right side. Good blocking by Lawson Evans, number one. Number 52, Trent Wright with a good block. And then, of course, the host of backs that lead through.
Sam McPherson comes into the game, another little brother of a famous older brother.
And here we go. And Matt Massengill comes over to catch a little breather and get some water. Second down and four to go. So here goes the Vikings. See the busting up the middle. Just going to grind it out.
John Hendry.
Great pickup. But it's so hard to find the ball in this offense.
It really is. This is an offense that Gene Stallings would be proud of.
Yeah. You know what, though? Gene Stallings won.
Yeah, that's right.
He's got a ring.
He's got a ring.
So does Chuck and Douglas.
There ain't nothing I'd rather do than run this kind of offense. I tell you what, Chuck and Douglas run it to a tee. Oh, and offsides by the Jets, not watching the ball. They'll pick up 5 yards for the Vikings to give us a first down. I'm sorry if I keep saying that. I'm going to try and be non-biased. I do have a son out there playing in the game, and I do catch myself saying that every once in a while. But Jets, I love you. J-E-T-E-S, Jets, Jets, Jets. I love you. We're all Spartans.
That's right.
Vikings first down, 8:40 to go in the second quarter. Once again, just right up the middle. And the bus. John Hendry scored several. He was a leading scorer for the Vikings this year. Scored many touchdowns. I think he scored his first touchdown this year. And he scored many after that. I called him the bus because he will smash it up and run. So, once again, both teams will call in plays looking at their wristbands. Matt Massengill takes it around right in. And the host of Sparta Jets over there to make the tackle. Heath Griffin, number 67. I saw Toriano scraping down the line. Number five out there for the Jets, making the Howell fell.
And Baldwin.
And I tell you, Jackson Young, number 15, cornerback on that side.
Third and two.
This is a critical.
7:36 to go.
Critical point of the drive.
In the game.
Here.
Vikings are trying to answer the Jets' first touchdown drive. Thomas Marriott gets the ball. He is met. I tell you what, number 67. Will Toriano make the tackle? But number five also applying the pressure that time. Howell fell. And John Colvin coming up. Fourth and four. And the Vikings will go for it.
It'll be time for that little jet sweep spinner play that Coach Grant puts in.
That's right. Yeah, you'll hear a lot of Omaha, red five, red nine. Douglas Grant calls the offensive plays for the Vikings.
He does a great job. He takes care of these kids. He makes it special. When you're on a Grant team, you get a lot of extra perks. Your own website, everything else.
Oh, terrific job by P Money, number 23, Parker Belt, making the tackle. I will tell you, I called a game when this group was third graders, Super Bowl. Parker Belt was on that team that won the Super Bowl. He's a terrific defensive
end. Is that a little brother?
A little brother.
Shocker.
I was about to say.
Outstanding.
So the Jets.
Varsity player.
That's right. The Jets have stopped the Vikings. And once again, like we say, all these guys are like little brothers of somebody. They've all been beaten up
survived.
In the back.
Yeah, survived the basement.
That's what I like about this grade. You know, they are, when they become Spartans, they will have taken all the whipping.
Yeah, and the Colvins and the
you look at them. I mean, just on this field right now, the Colvin, the Belts,
the Griffins. There's four Griffins. Each in those
yeah.
families.
Yeah. All right, Jets take the ball. Heath takes a snap, gives it to Parker Belt, number 23. And look at old Parker, takes it around the right end and making the tackle for the Vikings, number two, Matt Massengill.
Saw Trent Wright on that play, cover sideline to sideline. That was impressive.
Look at some of the remarks that the coaches talk about Trent, number 52 for them. I mean,
he, leader of the team, highly skilled on both sides. He knows when to turn it on and when to dominate and when his team needs him the most. Really well liked by his team. And he's the most talented Viking lineman in the history of Chuck and Douglas.
Pretty special.
That means a lot.
That means a lot. And I'll tell you what, there goes Heath up the middle. And once again, there's a host of Vikings on the tackle. Let's see who comes up from the bottom. Looks like Daniel Cubison, number 34. And
for a Jet, first down.
So Jets, though, get a first down here. They've got the ball on the 40-yard line. Jets are looking really impressive right now. 4:30 to go in the second quarter here. There you go, Jacob Rosenthal. Jacob Rosenthal is one of the hardest hitters, but I'll tell you, he is a downhill runner, number seven for the Jets. I had the awesome responsibility of coaching him in third grade, and he was a tough cookie then. He was the one that would hit. Has an old brother that trained him well.
And a lot of these kids, just because they're on the line right now, maybe a weight restriction issue. A lot of these kids, when they go on to the next level, they become linebackers, running backs, quarterbacks.
That's right.
You know, none of mine ever played a play except for on the line. And turned out they understood how to read a block. They understood a lot of things from that experience that were able to put them in a position to be successful at a higher level.
John Colvin taking it around left end for a first down. You're exactly right. These guys next year are going to figure out different positions. And some are going to be told they're first string, some will be second string, some will be running backs, might be offensive guards. But I tell you what, this is a tough group. Stick together and get up to Coach Yeager and say, where do you need me?
And it's an exciting time at the junior high. I just came through that program as well with my second son. Coach Jones, these kids are in great hands. You know, he's doing a little different than Coach Morrow. You only play one way.
Yep.
And so these kids are really prepared.
That's awesome.
When they get up there to Coach Yeager.
Jets on the 30-yard line. And just a little bit of movement by the Jets here.
I wish we had Coach Bowers jump on slow motion. He cleared 6 feet in the air. He could have leaped over.
Coach Bowers will pace the sidelines back and forth. A true coach.
This is serious business for these guys. They prepare for half the year, and then they execute for half the year.
All right, we got now we're looking at a repeat of the first down. First down and about 13 yards to go, or what is that? No, something like that with our 8-yard first downs. Look at Heath running it hard. And Daniel Cubison over there make tackle. Matt Massengill coming around. Look at Coleman Bates, number seven. Number 13, Sam McPherson.
Daniel Cubison showed a lot of speed getting to that ball. That was impressive.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you know, Daniel is, just knowledge of football is incredible.
He comes from a long line of great Mountain Brook athletes as well.
What's great is he plays with instinct. And that's something you really can't coach. He just got it. Jets looking impressive. What a great job of that Jets offensive line right now that's moving the ball. Second down. Oh, it's another pass. This time the Vikings have it covered. And who was that on the sack for the
– I'll tell you what, Trent Wright, he's got a tall task going up against
Will Troiano.
Will Troiano.
Number 6'7".
He fought. He caused that congestion with that pursuit. A lot of lower legs. Just kept those feet – churning until he pushed the whole pile back that way.
2-minute warning. I tell you what, on that last play too, number 42, Thomas Marriott covered Gricasio, sort of saw him sneaking out there and recognized that and did a great job.
These are two well-coached teams. You can tell by the execution.
So 2 minute warning, the clock will stop, and we'll get going on the snap. Score is 8-0, the Jets. Jets trying to add to their lead. Third down and about 10. He takes it over to the left side. He's hit by, hit once, twice, three times. And I tell you what, he takes it up to the first down marker.
They have laundry down.
Uh-oh.
Glenn's calling it early.
Got a hold. Wow. What a run by Heath.
Oh, well, that was 10 yards after first contact.
I mean, and he just what a tough runner. But once again, I'm looking at the line up there, and I'm looking at Frank the Tank Barton, number 2. I see Rob Gillespie, number 11, Jay Davis, 79, 67, Will Toriano. And I'm trying to see who's on. Gry Cascio, number 9, is a tight end. They're doing a fantastic job of opening holes for these running backs. Number 3, too, starts with the Lewis Allen, the center.
Yeah.
Timeout Jets. And I tell you what, while we're at it, minute 52 to go in the second quarter here. Let me tell you about one of our sponsors. We have Capstone Collegiate Communities, LLC. Total portfolio includes 50 communities with over 32,000 beds and $1.3 billion in development costs. Capstone Collegiate Communities, LLC. Rob Howland, call him directly, 414-6416. And I'll tell you what, USA Football is a national organization the NBA has partnered with to ensure quality training and certification of all of our coaches, commissioners, and it's available to our NBA patrons. What a great job that the USA Football has done with Heads Up Football with us. And NBA would also like to thank UAB Sports Medicine for providing certified athletic trainers for all of our games. They've been fantastic this year. And we'll mention those names. The athletic trainer, Samantha Davis, Laurie Fincher, Wednesday Benusia, Connor Spitzer, Kali Cartmill, Laura Serrett, John Pellerin, Kevin Handel, and Kenneth Davis. And our one last sponsor that we'd like to thank, NBA would like to thank R360 for their sponsorship. Hey, without all you, we couldn't do these broadcasts here on Super Bowl Sunday, and these are memories for life, especially getting to listen to Rob's and my voice, George Palakis, for the rest of your life.
That's right. So we get to play this every Christmas.
Day. Every Christmas.
When
Grandma comes. Put this in and listen to us. And Daniel Edwards, who does the production of this, you won't find any better.
And has done it
better.
Since I was involved, which is 12 years ago. So.
That's right. Always here. Jets got it third down and 4:59 to go. Colvin throws it back. Oh, interception by number 2, Matt Massengill. Bingo going the other way. And he's still going running.
Wow, what a run after catch.
What a run after catch. A minute 39 to go here in the second quarter. Big interception by the Vikings. And there you go. You see them all getting a little chest bump there and having fun. Everybody's excited. All right.
Chuck Bowers with another hurdle. Good jump. Coach Chuck Myers.
I tell you, once again, Matt O'Rear and Boyd Dobbin and the coaches of the Jets, and Chuck Myers, Douglas Grant, fantastic job of both coaches. Who are into the game. They want to win.
Oh, both sets do. I know each of these guys. I get to work with all of them over the years.
First down on about the 34-yard line. Vikings take the snap. Hand it off to Spence Morano, number 4, coming around to the left side. Getting some key blocks down there to move that ball about 4 yards.
Powell fell with the tackle.
How about the block by George Palakis?
I tell you what.
Did you see that number 83 laid somebody out?
I tell you, he gives you every bit of his 70 pounds.
No, he did. That was great. He almost busted that play wide open.
And here we go. There we go. They've got the wedge, and they're moving, driving. Good block by Trent Wright getting to the second level. Vikings. Minute 6, got both their timeouts.
Third and short.
Do the Vikings have a long pass play?
You know, they do, but they haven't really shown it this year. They show it on extra points, but at some point, who knows. Here goes Matt Massengill. Round to the right. And yes, if you look at half of the players' comments, they call for those pass plays.
Okay.
But when you got it grinded out 3 yards in a cloud of dust, you keep it going. Here we go, 48 seconds to go. First down, Vikings trying to answer the Jets' score. Up, All right, the referee is trying out for the marching band. He's doing his whistle a couple of different times. Now we're going. Clocks are moving. Direct snap. Oh, here's the pass play right here. Up. Thomas escapes.
Again.
Wise play by Thomas. He was getting pressure that time by a host of Jets. Number 23, P Money, Parker Belt getting back there. Wisely holds on the ball.
I am very impressed with the football card style pictures of all the Vikings on the rail. This is very impressive.
I will tell you, we're going to go on and start her business tonight.
Oh, yeah?
Mary Margaret Hendry, who just does a terrific job. If you're ever on one of her teams, you don't care about the coaches. You want to get on Mary Margaret's team because everything like this gets taken care of. And it's like one of the most memorable seasons that you ever have. She'll do the pictures and the banners. And, I mean, it's all this stuff that she does. And she really needs to open up what we've talked about is her own little company that she consults with other team moms.
Oh, yeah.
And does it for them.
Well, this grade's double blessed with Wendy on the other side.
And Wendy on the other side.
These coaches are on autopilot for this year.
Well, that's exactly. So we need to put Wendy and Mary Margaret together.
And take over the world.
Take over the world. I'm telling you. I'll work for y'all. Just let me know what I need to do. Vikings down second down, down 8-0. And there's another pass play. Thomas Marriott wisely holds on to it. Spence Marano, it's covered. And the Vikings call a timeout.
It took a lot of discipline to not throw that ball. I know he wanted to, and that's impressive at this age because that could have resulted in an interception.
Interception, just keep giving us another chance to try and score. So third down and about 7. It's been a great, great first half here. Jets took the opening kickoff and marched it straight down the field. I tell you what, the Jets they do a great job of mixing it up. And I tell you what, those passes to Gry Cassio and John Colvin putting those right there in the basket, terrific plays. And I tell you what, here we got. Look, it's Bear. No, that's not Bear Bryant. That's Coach Yeager and Elaine Yeager having a date night up on the scaffold watching the ball game.
But their date nights mean they're scouting for future Spartans.
They're scouting for future Spartans, and Elaine is the number one scout.
That's right.
She knows what she's doing, but I tell you what, this shows you Coach Yeager really wants to watch and see these guys. And I tell you what, these guys they've loved going to his camp.
Coach Yeager, in the past, he's using this opportunity, and he'll go back and consult with the coaches and the commissioners. And it's not uncommon for one of these guys to get a handwritten note from Coach Yeager about this experience.
Third down and 7 for the Vikings. They take it. John Hendry takes the run. And 19 seconds. It's going to be a fourth down. No timeouts left for the Vikings. So they're going to try and sneak off maybe one last play. 7 seconds left. Clock dwindling down. Last play. Matt Massengill takes it around right in, and up there he goes.
Still on his feet.
Oh, and the end of the half ends with Matt Massengill with a good about 15-yard run for the Vikings.
I'll tell you, I'm really impressed. This is a very athletic grade. This has been fun to watch, and I've been involved now 12 years with this, and this grade's one of the more impressive athletic grades that I've seen.
Lots of speed going on. All right. Well, here we are on Super Bowl Sunday. We will come back. It's George Palakis, Rob Wetzler here with a host of others. And we'll be back for the second half of the sixth grade Super Bowl between the Jets and the Vikings. Jets up 8-0.
Tell you something you don't let anything, nothing, come between us.
On this team, we fight
and we shut them down.
because we can.
Welcome back to Spartan Stadium. George Palekas with Rob Wetzler here for the sixth grade Super Bowl between the number one regular season Jets versus the second seed Vikings. Jets are leading 8-0, and the Vikings will be getting the ball to start the second half. Pretty good ball game, huh?
It really is. It's really exciting to see all these kids and just all the time they put into this, 30 or more practices. They all want this. It's fun to watch. Although, by the way, special thanks to the commissioners, both the great commissioners.
Yeah, I tell you what, Brad Baker, who does the sixth grade and thankless job, and then Brian Lucas who's overall commissioner.
Just
you see Brad right now. If the camera's on him, he's running to the 20, to the hash mark. He's trying to get it over. He's like, oh man, can I make it? Trying to get to the sideline.
And
he gets
and
there, and
yes,
he does. He makes it. But I tell you what, Brad did a terrific job. All righty, start the game. The Vikings taking it. Oh, a little.
Just a little eager.
A little eager. The aggressive. Which will be a 5-yard penalty, but showing, like you said, the eagerness to get out there and make a play.
You cannot fault them for that.
So the Vikings looking to the sideline, getting their call, taking a look at their wristbands. And there goes the snap to Matt Massengill. Oh, right up there to the middle, following a host of blockers. And he gets about 7-yard gain and probably gets about.
And Johnny Colvin closed in hard on that.
Second in about 5. And look at old Johnny Colvin coming up and hitting. So here goes the Vikings, second and about 4 to go. There goes Matt Massengill again, taking a snap and getting it close to the first down marker, probably about a yard away. You see Douglas Grant calling the plays for the Vikings. 9:02 to go.
I bet you I can call this play. I bet you I know what Coach Grant's about to call.
What would you call it?
Well, just
Red 9.
Yeah.
Red 9, Omaha.
Well, there it is right there.
And it's close.
It
is close.
He'll do it again.
And it's fourth down.
Fourth down.
That was a tough spot.
It's a sixth grade football. And are they going to measure?
I know.
Glenn's going to use a second look. Oh, yeah, they are going to measure. I think he's got it.
So I'm trying to hear he come. I don't know. I think the Jets held him.
It's going to be really close.
Look at that. I think it's about an inch.
Ooh.
Yeah. Jets held him. All right, fourth down. Big play coming up. Jets digging in. That front line. Gillespie and Toriano and Cassio. And I can't see beyond Toriano. Who's that on the other side there? Digging in. Looks like Sokol. Yeah. They're digging in right now. Going to grab some dirt. On the offensive line of the Vikings, going to see if they can grind out a yard or an inch. And there goes the bus over to the left side, following John Henry taking over the left side over Reed Vickers and Palekas and Marks for a first down. First and 8. And there goes Massengill again taking the ball. Meeting the brick wall. Ooh, Toriano, number 67. And look who else is getting up. Look at that. Frank the Tank Look at Frank next to Toriano, number two, getting up there and mixing it in.
He did. That looks great.
I tell you, Frank is just a wonderful, wonderful kid. And he loves, loves, loves to mix it up in football. Good player. Vikings right now, second down and about six. And here it comes. They're coming back to the right. There goes Spence Morano, makes a good little miss. Spence, if Spence gets in the open, he will show his speed. And LaHosto, look at Cassio and Colvin and Griffin making the tackle. Fell over there.
Spence Colvin made a really good play, covered a lot of ground from that safety position.
That's key. When you have a good, strong safety like Colvin who can prevent the passes from coming your way and cover a lot of ground, does a great job. You see Young and Barton at the cornerbacks. Linebackers are Rosenthal and Griffin. And here goes big bus, John Hendry. Oh, and he's met.
What a play.
And I'm trying to see who is that. I think it was Heath Griffin, number 10.
That was Heath Griffin. That was a stick.
And met him in the hole.
That was a linebacker stick right there.
Fourth down again.
I love the technique. These kids really have learned the technique, the tackling, the roll tackling. They're doing everything they're supposed to do. Just a testament to Coach O'Rear, Coach Grant.
Yeah, these coaches go through their clinic. They take the training, and Mountain Brook Sports takes it seriously. And there goes Matt Massigan on fourth down. Oh, he fumbles it. And he recovers his own fumble, and that put him, helped him on the first down there.
First down.
5:48 to go in the third quarter here. So the Vikings are trying to sort of show what the Jets did, take up the whole half or whole quarter with their drive. Jets first up 8-0,
down,
third quarter.
31.
See the snap to the bus. John Hendry takes it up. Jacob Rosenthal in there on tackle.
Get an extra yard after. Great job.
Yeah, that's what I say. That's why I call for the bus, because John will take it and he will keep driving, and you will see everybody hop on him, and he keeps driving them. So to me, that's the bus.
Second down from the 28.
Once again, great job blocking up there by Trent Wright and Sam McPherson and Eli Bear, Reed Vickers, Marks, Palakis.
Look at the pull block. That was awesome.
And here he goes, Matt Massengill. I tell you, the pull block, you see what, number 52 pulling around.
That was a fantastic block.
I'm going to tell you, best technique you will see. He is just not only a wonderful player, as we say, but Trent is just a super person in life. And I'll tell you that about most of all these kids out here.
Yep.
They're just – tomorrow they're all
blessed.
Tomorrow they'll all be together on the playground playing together in their green and gold. First down for the Spartans, for the Vikings. And Daniel Kiebison, direct snap goes to him. And I tell you what, number 8 Sokols, who I saw make that hit, and Griffin coming up and tackling. Terrific job. Second down. That was a 2-yard loss. Great job, Sokol. Coming in there and scrounging through there to make that tackle.
What
we got?
I think we're going to have a illegal blitz. I think he got there before.
Came in between the tackles.
I think he –
yep.
Yeah. Well, they're going to call it offsides. I think he beat the and it's a really tough rule because, you know, it's outside the tackle box. Well, you know, it's only 2 people. So.
Well, you know, the thing is, and it's such a tough rule. That's the toughest rule we have.
Yeah.
Because when you have a player like you see on the other side here, that like a Heath Griffin or Jacob Rosenthal or on our side, when you see Dan Kubison, they know how to react to the ball. They're
right.
Scraping down.
Yeah, that's right.
And, you know, they're meeting up in that hole. It's just tough. It's a tough, tough play. But that's good. Good.
They'll get a pat on the back next year.
Yeah, next year they're going to love them.
This year it's instinct getting in the way.
All right. So it.
Not quite sure how he did the Markov thing.
Well, so it was against the.
It was offsides on the defense.
The marker's in the wrong space. There we go. the yard marker never moved. There we go. So second down and about six. Alan Palmer on the yard marker, just a little slow. Nobody told him to move. All righty. 3:33 to go here in the third quarter. Vikings are driving.
This quarter has been all Vikings.
20 yard line. And there we go. Oh, and it's a pass play. And it's a good pass to,
in and out of the hands.
To Spence Marano. Great pass by Thomas Marriott and John Colvin on the coverage.
Colvin's all over the place.
And you hear screaming from the sidelines. Clock!
And the rules are different.
The rules are different. But everybody's an expert.
Yep. Even if you played eight games already, they still are experts.
Third down. Here comes the sweep again. Massengill takes it around. Massengill cuts it. Keep it moving. There he go. Good tackle there by the Jets.
This is quite a drive.
Once again, John Colvin in on the tackle. And Parker Belt. I tell you what, good block by number 42, Thomas Marriott right there. And, of course, Sam McPherson and Lawson Evans, Trent Wright, sealing the edge and allowing Massengill to get around.
I'm really impressed with Sam McPherson's plays.
Yeah, I'm about to say, you'll read what the coaches say about Sam. He's solid in fundamentals and a great blocker. But he is just – he's Mr. Consistency. There goes the bus moving up the middle. And he's pulled back by – stopped by Gry Cassio and Will Toriano and John Colvin again and P. Money, Parker Belt. A minute 51 to go, the third quarter. And it's a second down and six. Vikings on about the 14-yard line. Massengill takes it around the sweep, and here he goes. Moves it, cuts it towards the middle. Oh, but we're going to have a flag. We got a yellow hanky. Massengill takes it down to 2-yard line, but I'm afraid this one might be coming back.
I can tell by Chuck Bowers' reaction. He saw something.
We have a hold on the Vikings. So holding happening somewhere on that right side. And now that's a tough one.
That's a serious penalty there.
Yeah. So that'll mark you back to the 20.
It's an 8-yard penalty in this league.
Yeah.
Significant.
So
sometimes the refs forget and do a full 10.
Full 10, that's right. Here we go. Once again, we're second and 4:59 to go. Massengill takes it to the right, sweep this time. Jackson Young coming
that
up.
That is a stick. Who was that?
I tell you what, it's number 10, Heath Griffin, with a solid hit. But I tell you who started that play was number 15, Jackson Young, playing outside in at cornerback, turned that ball back into the linebacker.
Great containment. Great containment. You can't get by these guys.
No, you can't. And I tell you what, Jackson playing fundamental football like that, Young, outside in, hey, it helps the linebacker. It turns it right back into Heath to give him a solid hit. Third down and about 14. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. The Vikings have taken the ball the entire quarter. Gene Stallings would be proud. Oh, and so reverse around to Spence Marano and the lead of blockers around in front of him. Good blocking that time. Pulling by Trent Wright to pull around.
We may have a player down.
And we have a player down. Yeah, it looks like Heath Griffin, and hopefully he's okay.
I got taking a shot to the back.
I tell you right now, we need to, with this injury right here, we want to thank our sponsors, UAB Sports Medicine, for providing their certified athletic trainers for us. I tell you, this right here, you know, both of us have been on the ball field and coached and done this for years and years. Great to see Heath up. Good. But I tell you, when you sit back and think 15, 20 years ago and something, the injury would happen,
oh, yeah.
We were the athletic trainers and we're the ones having to take over.
Me with all my pipe salesman experience.
Yeah. You know, it's not that by saying we might be able to give you some the pipe experience, financial experience, whatever it might be. But this has been so wonderful for us, and we really appreciate that. I hope Heath's okay, but I know he's in good hands as they check him out. It's fourth down.
A shot to the back.
I tell you, he is a tough player too. So fourth down right now. For
see what wrinkle, Coach Grant has
9 yards
sleeve.
To go. Oh, it's another pass play. Thomas gets out. He's going to run. He's going to try and get there. And he just ran into his own little player.
Number eight.
Sokol.
Slate Sokol.
What a terrific job by Slate. I tell you, Thomas trying to make it there and just ran right into our own little player. This will be the end of our third quarter. We'll take a break. And we got end of third quarter, the Jets 8, Vikings 0.
Let me tell you something, you don't let anything, nothing, come between us.
On this team, we fight.
And we shut them down because we can't.
Welcome back here to Spartan Stadium, where the J-E-T-S, Jets, lead the Vikings 8-0. At the start of the fourth quarter, the Vikings took the opening snap from third quarter and exhausted the clock. And
great ball control with that penalty really set them back a little bit.
Back. Slate Sokol making a great tackle to get the ball turned over to the Jets. Heath Griffin takes a direct snap. And, do I see a
– I think the ball's on the ground.
I see – look at number 42, Thomas Marriott, coming up with it. The only way I could tell that was a fumble was I saw Coach Byers jump 50 feet in the air, and I knew something had happened. Look at Coleman Bates coming over. But number 42, Thomas Marriott, with a big play. Heath had a good run, and – Thomas just kept playing to the whistle. 9:19 to go. The Vikings. Massico takes a direct snap. Oh, and he's hit by number 7, Jacob Rosenthal. Number 10, Heath Griffin finishing it. And look at number 2, Frank the Tank, slapping Rosenthal around, telling him a good tackle. Second down, and about 8 to go. Once again, the excitement I have for next year and the years to follow of these fellow Spartans is great. There goes a little counter step by John Hendry, and just the block. We just couldn't quite master that block, and John gets tackled for a fail to gain. Third down.
Did Colvin get all the way up from safety?
Oh, yeah. I tell you, that's the key when you have a safety that can come up and fill the gap and tackle. Now, what that does is, if you got a safety that's coming up, you throw it over the middle and get behind it.
Yeah, he's maybe taking some risks, but it's paying off.
But it's sixth grade football.
Oh, yeah.
That's a risk I'm going to take.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Come up and meet the runner. As a reverse to Daniel. There he goes all the way. John Colvin's the last man to get him. And, great tackle by John Colvin to the one. Nice reverse back to Daniel Cubison.
Touchdown
and
saving
DK taken out at the 1 yard line.
That was a great play.
That was great play. Great play call. And here we are, first and goal now for the Vikings with 7:34 to go in the fourth quarter.
I don't think this one's over yet.
I don't either, no. And here we go up the middle. Oh, but a goodie. Look at that. Big Will keep on turning. I tell you what, Big Will Torriano right there in the middle.
You may want to go to the outside when you're up against
him.
Yeah,
I tell you what. When Donald Trump talks about a wall, that might be the kind of wall he would want to build right there. One that's active. Way to go, Will. Good tackle.
They're going to run it again.
Second down and two. Here goes Matt Messingill. He's in for the end zone. Great blocking. He runs behind. Look at that. Trent Wright leading him through.
Yeah, that was a great block by Trent.
And Lawson Evans over there with a big, big block. And Eli, the line. Terrific job. I'm trying to see who was on the end there. It might have been Spence Morano. But Reed Vickers, well marked. And George Palakis at the end over there. Vikings will go for a two-point conversion.
Critical, critical. This could be
8-6.
With 6 minutes left, this is very important.
So here we go. The Vikings line up.
Oh, that was it.
Yeah, that was it. Vikings called timeout. They showed the play. And
1:37.
So here's our 6:51 to go. Once again, we want to thank our sponsors that we've had today. I tell you what, Rob Howland, Capstone Collegiate Communities LLC, and Rob's son's doing a fantastic job, Lewis, at center and on defense for the Jets. It's the Capstone Collegiate Communities.com. At www.capstonecollegiatecommunities.com. Go visit that site. Capstone's Collegiate Communities LLC's total portfolio includes 50 communities with over 32,000 beds and $1.3 billion in costs. Give Rob a call today, direct line 414-6416. Then we have USA Football, a national organization that NBA has partnered with to ensure quality training and certification of all our coaches, commissioners, and is available to our NBA patrons. Thank you. And NBA would like to thank R360 for their sponsorship today. Let's get back to the extra point. Here we go. With 6:51 to go, Vikings called timeout, changed the play up. Oh, and there we go. We got an offsides that time. And it looks like, I don't know, that Eli looked like he got his foot stepped on. Once again, Eli Bear, who we call the quarterback of the offense, with the center position.
Now, does this change the play for Coach Grant, or does he go with it?
I think he probably goes with the same play, just got him closer with the play he wanted to run. So here we go. The Jets aren't going to be fooled with anything. There's a snap, there's a block, and there's a reverse around, and there's Cubison. Is he in? He is in.
We have a tie ball game.
And tie ball game.
As it should be, sixth grade Super Bowl.
8-8, and you see the coaches excited, the players are excited. Great blocking on the left side over there. And here it comes. Big G coming off with the football for them.
He's taking that to the house.
He takes it to the house. As you, if you got, you see G holding the football. You see the great work by Mountain Brook Sporting Goods and the numbers, and how they stick on the jerseys. But we didn't want to get his numbers put back on because we didn't want to break the mojo.
Oh yeah, no, you can't do that.
Can't break mojo.
Mojo is very important.
All right. So now the Jets, Jets, Jets. We'll try and see, get the ball moving.
So Jets have only won one offensive play in this half.
This half.
Well, that could be a record.
I mean, he's amazing. All righty, the Jets, Heath Griffin back it. He's got Jacob Rosenthal coming around, and I'll tell you what, Jacob coming around to the left end, and Thomas Marriott there. And he's met by number 43, John Hendry.
Some good speed.
And look at that. I look at old E. Bear doing a great job helping him up. Pat him on the back saying good run. Good sportsmanship. All right, great run by Jacob. Jacob showing his speed and getting to the edge for a good 5-yard gain. Second down for the Jets. Once again, Heath Griffin back behind. And he takes the direct snap and zigzags around. We're going to have a flag in there.
We had a little bit of a hold.
Landed about the hold.
Mr. Glenn gives us the hold signal.
On the Jets. You know, it's been amazing how many Vikings teams have made the Super Bowl today.
Yeah, it goes in spurts.
And the Jets, of course. And I'm like, think about real NFL football. You think the Jets or Vikings will ever make it to the Super Bowl?
Not since Fran Tarkenton.
No, not. So,
and Joe Namath.
But we got the real Jets and the real Vikings here.
It's funny how that happens, though. It's either all Redskins, all Raiders, all Vikings this year.
Packers got kicked out of the league this year because none of the teams won last year. So they kicked the Packers out. Jets have it second down and Highway 31 to go. P Money takes the ball. Parker Belt gets around the left side, but he gets met. And I'm trying to see who was that on the tackle there, Rob. Looked like Spence Marano.
Spence Marano.
Number
sure
four,
was.
The missile.
Third down and 11.
Third down and 11. 5:19 to go in a tight game, 8-8. And here we are in the fourth quarter.
We've not had a punt yet this game, have we?
No, we haven't had a punt. And, I feel like we're watching a game that Pat Dye and Gene Stallings would be arm-in-arm around just loving.
Like the Mississippi State-Auburn 3-2 victory of
that's right.
2002, whenever it was.
Third down and 9 to go. Colvin takes it. Oh, the ball's up in the air. Oh, who caught it?
Still in the air.
Oh. I'll tell you what, I thought Toriano might catch it.
He may have hit Toriano's head.
Yeah, I'm about to say. It got tipped up, and I don't know who tipped it on the line there. But a great job by the Vikings tipping it up. A great job by the Jets to knock it down.
Fourth down. You think Air Colvin's about to make a debut here?
I'm going to tell you.
Second half debut?
I'm going to tell you right now. You can rest assured that the number one or number 10 will be touching the ball, but John Colvin can sling it. And with the players you have, it's amazing. I mean,
his older brother was in the trenches guy. You know, Sam, we claimed he led the all-time Mountain Brook athletic sack record. Yeah, like 35 sacks in four years, you know.
Yeah.
But seeing Johnny out there as a skill position.
They decided to punt with 3:50 to go, which is playing field position, which is probably wise right now. But yeah, you're right. Sam Colvin, a great high school player. Love calling number 91.
But never the skill position guy that Johnny is.
Johnny's got the skills.
The moves like Jagger.
Yeah. But Sam now moves his talents to the basketball side.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Thomas Marriott was given the play by Coach Grant. He's running in. Jets now got to hunker down to stop the Vikings. You know, Jets punting it thinking, you know, they're going to grind it out. So, see what happens. Direct snap. And there goes Thomas Marriott around the edge trying to get there. Oh, look, nice move by Thomas Marriott doing some sidestep to get close to a first down. Good run by Thomas. Second down and two to go. Gorgeous evening here in Spartan Stadium.
Great temperature. Got to be 65 degrees.
It's 60. Football weather. And there's a great game going on between the Vikings and Jets. And there's a snap to the bus. John Hender, who takes it. And just moves it up the middle. 2:53 to go. And I'm trying to think. The Vikings have one timeout, I think. And the Jets should have two timeouts.
We got ourselves a football game.
The clock will stop with 2 minutes to go. We got 2:38. First down. Vikings take the snap, and it's Matt Matzengill following a host of blockers. And, boom, Jacob Rosenthal making the tackle. And I look at number five for the Howell Fell. Frank the Tank in there nearby. I tell you, Rob Gillespie, once again, I just see that front line of the Jets doing a really good job. Both lines are battling each other. Rob Gillespie doing a great job on the Jets sidelines. See, grab dirt that time. Matt Massengill moves it through. And Frank the Tank making the tackle.
They have picked out a spot they like to run, and they're hitting it hard.
Well, you know you're going to run behind your screen.
That's right.
And you got 2 minute warning right here.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with the Vikings blocking.
And
that entire line is, I mean, making some serious blocks.
Well, I'm going to tell you, in all my years of seeing it, Coach Byers and Coach Grant, there's not a better system, not a better practice. Everything are drills, and it's all USA football. And these guys learn the fundamentals before they get up to
And that's what's so important.
That's what's important. The Vikings got it first down. Oh, we got a flag. We got movement in the backfield.
Coach Jones is excited to get all these kids that have learned the fundamentals. It takes it allows him at the junior high to really get into what he needs to do. He's only got so much time to put together his team.
Well, that's the thing I see about both these teams, the Jets. The teams that have made it here are teams that have made it through the regular season, but they've had terrific coaching. You look at the Jets and the way they play and the way they're sticking it, same thing. And it's just it's a tribute to these coaching staffs, both sides. First down and about 14. Hand off to Spence Morano, who gets met by number 10, Heath Griffin, for about a two-yard gain.
Coach O'Rear spent a lot of time with Coach Yeager before he took this job this year, just getting prepared and making sure that he was in a position to really contribute. And obviously, he's here tonight, so it worked out.
He has done a fantastic job. Been very impressed with his play calling. Second down and 10. Massengill gets it around the left side, and who's Griffin covering the ground? Sideline to sideline.
Yeah, that was impressive.
Number 10, Heath Griffin.
Third down, Vikings.
I tell you what.
There's three or four of these guys that could have helped the eighth grade out.
I'm telling you, it's just fun to see. So here we go, minute 6 to go. Score's tied 8-8. Vikings got it third down. Vikings with one timeout. The Jets with two. Vikings are going to start managing the clock a little bit here, these next two plays. And there's the snap. And there's a fake reverse, and they're going to pass it. And it is,
in and out of the hands.
I tell you what, Frank Barton and I tell you, John Colvin sort of causing the disruption on that.
That would have been six there.
And so I tell you what, it's one of those things. 42 seconds left. The coaches are now faced with, you know, a fourth down call. What do you do?
Douglas is one of the best auditors I know. He's going to punt.
And there they go.
George Polakis with a beautiful punt.
Oh, my good friend Wayne Trucks on the PA announcement over there. Calling the punt. But we'll call number 83 there for the punt. I love it.
That was a good punt.
That was a very good punt. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Ooh, that looks like, do I see like a prevent a little further back?
There
could be dangerous.
Number 83 there holding the ball right there. All right, here we go. Jets got the snap, and there's a quick pass out to Heath Griffin. Oh, he's got room. There he goes. He's moving, running for a good 10-yard gain.
Now the clock will stop while they set the chains, and then they'll restart the clock.
25 seconds with the clock right now, and we got timeout. Jets have one timeout left. The Vikings have one timeout, but a great play to get a quick pass out to Heath Griffin. All John needs is about 10 more yards, and he'd throw a Hail Mary down to the end zone.
Well, he'll definitely try.
But once again, we thank our sponsors. We thank the commissioners. I'll tell you what, Brian Lucas, overall commissioner, what he's done for this year and the football and some of the changes he's made. It's fantastic. I'm trying to see if I see Brian out there. Yeah, Brian's out there around the goal line over there talking with some of the coaches. You see also Brad Baker on about the 25-yard line. Brad's a sixth-grade commissioner. And once again, thankless job. What these guys do.
A lot of time goes into this stuff. Yeah. A lot of heartbreak. A lot of
I mean, there's no gift cards no fan parties or anything like that for you.
No, you pretty much got to watch yourself in the Piggly Wiggly. You may take a tomato to the back of the head.
He will.
That's your claim to fame.
That's your claim to fame. So thank both Brian and Brad for this. So Jets on the move. 25 seconds left. Here we go. It's first down on their 30. Another quick pass out to P Money. Just a little too much pepper on that one.
Almost looked like that may have been a double pass.
I think you're right because I saw Jacob Rosenthal going
after,
out. Yeah. And I'm about to say, but wisely, OE over there, E-Bear, sees it. All right, second down. Clock stops. 22 seconds left. Jets have the ball. Second and 8. Super Bowl 6th grade Sunday here. And I tell you, the last time these guys will don the NBA colors here, the green and white and purple and gold. Next year it's green and gold. Here we go, second down. John Colvin behind center, takes it, fakes the pass to Heath, goes downfield to Jagra.
Oh, in and out of his hands.
Great stop by Eli Bear to knock it down, but Gra casts you on a beautiful pattern. And I mean, nothing wrong with that pattern. And a good throw. Eli Bear just made a great play on the ball. Third down, 18 seconds to go.
Burn their last time out.
Last time out for the
interesting call.
I tell you what, so once again, I tell you, great job by both coaching staffs, Matt O'Rear and Boyd Dobbin and Howie Fell, on the Jets, and then Chuck Byers and Douglas Grant on the Vikings. And then these players, what a game they have played. Fantastic. You know, we ask them to provide us information in case we ever need information. I tell you, it ends up probably being on our, you know, some fun stuff we all get to carry around and look at ourselves. But, you know, you look at these guys and, you know, what play would you run, Jets? If a coach let you run a play, there, we got John Colvin saying double pass. We got one saying the bomb, reverse pass, flea flicker, Hail Mary, fake 25, Rob corner, long pass to me. That is that's a Parker Belt. So they got a lot of pass plays here. Here it is on third down. John Colvin uncorks a long one. That's intercepted. That's intercepted by – oh, it's a flea flicker. The ball's on the ground. Oh, no. Oh. Who comes up with it? So, Eli Bear with the great interception.
That could have got really interesting.
It really could have.
Possession could have remained with the Jets.
It really could have. And it's one of those things I didn't know what Coach Grant was going up to do. But
great. I don't think they went over that in practice.
No. So here we are with 5 seconds left in the ball game. You know, Eli Bear making a huge interception for the Vikings. He will now quarterback the Vikings from the center position. 5.8 seconds. Vikings have one timeout. So let's see what's going to happen. And there's first down. There's a snap. Thomas Marriott uncorks it, a long one. Uh-oh. Interception. Oh, no, here we go. It's the flea flicker back. And there we go. Heath Griffin's going back the other way. This is playground football at its best. But a tackle by number 52, Trent Wright, to end it.
Trent said, I'm going to fix this. He said, I'm going to fix this and take him down.
So now we – do not end in a tie.
No. Super Bowl.
We go Super Bowl. We go to overtime rules.
Penetration.
So I'll tell you what we'll do. We're going to go find out those overtime rules, and we'll come back in just a moment for a fantastic 6th grade Super Bowl game between the Vikings and Jets. 8-8 coming overtime coming up next.
something you don't let anything, nothing, come between us.
On this team, we fight.
And we shut them down because we can't.
All righty, welcome back to Super Bowl Sunday, sixth grade football, Jets versus Vikings overtime. Just like we drew it up, 8-8 right now. And I'm George Palakis along with Rob Wetzler. Rob, you want to tell us what the rule is going to be for this overtime?
Yeah, free football, first of all. We get to see a little more football.
That's right.
Sixth grade, you can just extend your last bit of your sixth grade. We're playing a 10-yard penetration, Alabama High School rules. Actually, let me rephrase that.
Yeah, eight-yard penetration. That's right.
So you cannot get a first down short of a penalty. You have four downs to get the ball in the end zone. Then you would go for either a one-point conversion or a two-point conversion. If it goes to extended, for instance, the Vikings will be on defense first, then they will get a chance at offense just like the Jets did, and then it would reverse. So you go defense to offense, offense back to defense.
All righty. Thank you for that explanation, and here we go. To start the first overtime, Jets have the ball. Heath Griffin behind center takes it over to the right guard. And Griffin, boom, goes for about a four-yard gain. Good blocking over there on that right side. Looked like Rob Gillespie over there and Jay
Spence
Davis.
Marano.
Yeah, and then on the tackle, looked like Spence Marano.
Did a good job.
But I tell you what, once again, great job blocking out over there by the Jets. I've seen it all day with Jay Davis and Gillespie and Sokol. That time, it was Will Troiano, looks like, on the right side. Will gets the ball. Heath gets the ball, takes it right over the middle again, following the big hog. Will Troiano, he's on the one-yard line, third down.
Inside the one. Third and goal.
So no question what the Jets are wanting to do. They're power football right now.
We need a trainer on the Viking sideline, please.
We got an injury right now, and here sports medicine is coming over right now. Looks like Reed Vickers, who has a little bit of an injury. Thank you again for their sponsorship this whole year. Third and goal for the Jets. Once again, I wonder who's going to get the ball. Heath Griffin takes the snap, goes right over the right side.
He
got through. He pushed his legs on through for a touchdown. It almost looked like he was stopped, but no. I tell you what, Heath Griffin showing what most good backs show. Keep your legs driving. Good things will happen for a touchdown. So now the Jets are up 14-8 here in the first overtime.
Going for one.
They're going to go for one.
Playing it safe.
Very interesting.
They'll go for one, leading 14-8.
A lot of confidence in his defense, Coach Rivera has.
Yep. Fantastic job. Reed Vickers still being looked at by the sports medicine on the sideline. Once again, we thank them. They are here. Jets line up for the extra point. Coach O'Rear shouting out some encouragement and remarks. Heath Griffin takes it right up the middle, and he gets it in for the extra one point, which makes it 15-8.
The Vikings will get the same opportunity.
So Vikings will take the ball off the 8-yard line. They have four downs to get it in the end zone, barring any penalties. So, once again, the Jets defense will dig in their cleats.
Be a heck of a time to throw to that little tight end.
I tell you right now, let's just get in the end zone any which way we can. So here we go. The The Vikings have the ball, and direct snap to Massengill over to the right side. And boom, a good little 3 or 4 yard gain. Once again, we're in our first overtime. Jets took the had the possession first, took it in the end zone, got the extra point, 1 point. They're up 15-8.
Second and goal
for the Vikings.
Interesting, they're running right at the big man. They're running right at
him.
Troiano.
And you'll see both teams have Trent Wright and Troiano, and they'll just swap them back and forth. So direct snap once again to, looks like big bust, John Hendry in for the touchdown.
Here we go.
Here we go. Coach Grant and Coach Byers talking with each other. They're going to go for one.
I could have predicted that before you even took over that drive.
The accountant.
Yes.
That's right.
He's a good one.
That's right. So here we go. It's 15-14. Ball set up on the 3 yard line for the extra point, 1 point. Timeout. And they're going to talk about it.
They cannot change their mind once they set the ball down.
As we prepare for the conversion, remember.
So, once again, we want to thank our sponsors that we've had today. Once again, USA Football. It's a national organization that NBA has partnered with to ensure quality training and certification of all of our coaches, commissioners, and is available to our NBA patrons. NBA, we thank them enough, but we're going to say it again. NBA would like to thank UAB Sports Medicine for providing certified athletic trainers for all the games as they are attending to one of our players right now. Rob Howland, Capstone Collegiate Communities, LLC. Total portfolio includes 50 communities with over 32,000 beds and $1.3 billion in development costs. Call Rob Howland, 205-414-6416, or visit capstonecollegiatecommunities.com. And here we are coming to the final play. And NBA would like to thank through R360 for their sportsmanship. Vikings, here we go on their extra point. And the snap. Oh! The Vikings had moved the ball back to the five, hoping to draw the Jets offside to move them up. But instead, the Vikings jumped offside.
That is a bummer.
That's a big one. So, once again, the Vikings have to look and see what's in their bag of tricks here. And here we go. The extra point is a tough one from the 10. Down 15-14. Viking snap. And there we go. Oh, an incomplete pass. I tell you what. And Jets stopping in. What a victory by the Jets. 15-14.
What a ball game.
Number 10 looks like Heath Griffin knocking the pass down, a pass that was intended for Daniel Cubison. And once again, the Jets will regular season champs will take the Super Bowl championship. But what a tough game and what a great game.
What a great game.
By both teams.
And I've seen a lot of these. This is a very talented group of players. I'd heard a lot about the sixth grade from many folks, but I got to see it firsthand tonight. This is going to be impressive for Coach Jones next year at the junior high. He's going to have a lot to work with.
Well, the key thing is we need to keep 45 players in each class. If we do that, we're doing good. And I tell you what, this class is going to go over 45.
That's
Coach Yeager. So we'll get ready here for the trophy presentation. Once again, the Jets winning a dramatic game here on Super Bowl Sunday, sixth grade football, 15-14. And we'll be getting the trophies. Vikings, nothing.
Coach Yeager makes his way out.
Yeah,
again,
Coach,
we're so blessed, guys.
That's right. Coach Yeager
and
Coach's wife, Elaine Yeager, that's out there with us. Brian Lucas, the overall commissioner. Brad Baker, who is here. But I'll tell you what we'll do is we will, as soon as they're ready, we'll cut over and break over to the Wayne Trucks to give out the trophies when they're ready. And then we'll wrap it up here. So here we go.
Teams
are about to line up. Coaches are talking to them right now. And we're getting them lined up. Once again, great job by Matt O'Rear, Boyd Dobbin, and Howie Fell for the great coaching job they did with the Jets. And I tell you what, we're going to hear all those Jets names called back out here in just a minute. But what a fabulous job, both offensively and defensively, by the Jets. Vikings, just a great, great season, great coaches. You got to thank, you know, Chuck Byers and Douglas Grant. And really, we need to be thinking of probably wives, Laurie and Marcy, of both of those guys for all the time they've spent in this league and what they do. And so, so here are the Jets. We see the Jets facing us. They're about to receive their trophy. And here come the Vikings.
And I don't think Johnny Colvin's hair is even moved.
No, it's perfect.
Yeah, like his brother Sam.
Smooth.
Ladies, man.
We got to figure out, maybe we're just Smooth. That might be a new nickname. He doesn't have a nickname down here, so we might just call him Smooth. All your friends are going to be calling you that when you're 65 watching this DVD.
And they will keep watching it as we still watch our 2007 third grade Super Bowl.
That's right.
Quite often.
We'll give it over to Wayne Trucks for the trophy announcements.
Coaches Douglas Grant and Chuck Bowers. Number one, Lawson Evans. Number two, Matt Massengill. Number four, Spence Morano. Number seven, Coleman Bates. Number eight, Eli Bear. Number 13, Sam McPherson. Number 34, Daniel Cubison. Number 42, Thomas Marriott. Number 43, John Hendry. Number 52, Trent Wright. Number 83, George Palakis. Number 89, Wells Marks. And we'd also like to recognize number 74, Reed Vickers. How about another round of applause for the Vikings, your second place sixth grade Super Bowl finishers. And now, your sixth grade Super Bowl champions, the Jets. Head coach, Matt O'Rear, Boyd Dobbin, and Howie Fell. Number 00, Walker Ray. Number two, Frank Barton. Number one does come first, John Colvin. Number three, Lewis Howland. Number five, Howell Bell. Number seven, Jacob Rosenthal. Number eight, Slate Sokol. Number nine, Gry Cascio. Number 10, Heath Griffin. Number 11, Rob Gillespie. Number 15, Jackson Young. Number 23, Parker Belt. Number 67, Will Troiano. And number 79, Jay Davis. Once again, congratulations to your sixth grade champions, the Jets.
Thank you, Wayne Trucks, for the trophy presentation. Well, Rob, I tell you what, another fine season under the belts, but this is the last season these guys will be, like we say, wearing these different colors. They're going to be wearing one color next year. And I tell you what, the green and gold, they're Spartan men now.
That's right.
What does that mean to us?
I tell you, it's about being part of a team, being part of something bigger than yourself, and if everybody does their part, there's no cap on what we can do.
No cap. And I'll tell you what these guys have got to do is encourage their teammates and these other teams that did not make it here. We need 45 players in our senior class, 45 to 50 players.
It's really if the group stays together and moves ahead as one, you're gonna have a great experience. I just came off it with my older son. What a fantastic opportunity.
And Will Wetzler, who got to speak to these guys, and these guys, he's heroes to everybody. Guys, you keep moving, keep playing, keep believing, you end up like number 25 for the green and gold.
He had a lot of help.
All right. Well, hey, I'm George Palakis, Rob Wetzler. We've enjoyed this ball game. Super Bowl Sunday, sixth grade football. The Jets, J-E-T-S, Jets, with a 15-14 victory over the Vikings. Thanks a lot, and have a great tomorrow.